illustrate your team and the Vice Captain. I'm going to talk to you about the results in week 2 of the AGC competition. All teams will wash out except for the Assumption College vs Campbell Grammar game. We'll now go on to the highlights of this game. The average was reduced to a 20 over the innings because the umpires thought it was going to rain and get washed out. The pitch was damp because of the rain that happened overnight, so the outfield was slow and that not many boundaries were scored in this game. So Assumption won the toss and elected to bat. So Assumption ran in with Lyle and Webby opening the bat. Lyle faced first ball and got a duck. So Crowley came in at first drop and kept the innings together, making a solid 35. Soon enough, Webb was out for 12 and he came back to his bowled out soon after that, after 4 balls. Campbell were on a rise and we looked in trouble. So Crowley kept batting on with O'Connor who made 12, and eventually Crowley retired on 35 to get out the balls with AGC cricket in the third. So Crowley hit 3 fours and 2 sixes. That was his highlights of his innings. The other standout with the bat was Nixon who made 34. Also kept the innings going. After that, Goffey came in at 6, who held his 6th wicket with a 12-ball duck. Even though he didn't score any runs, he did keep his wicket until he got out in 2 over, of course. The captain of the side, Colin Gravney, came in at number 8 and made a quick 8 before being caught at deep long on. Vice Captain Harding finished off the innings with 1-off-1 ball, equaling his best strike rate of 100. The general score at the end of the innings was 7-115 off 20 overs. This is actually a low score compared to other first games, and this gave Campbell Grammar a chance. By the way Campbell Grammar batted, they had no chance. Campbell came into bat and they made a solid start, and then Glenny came on to bowl, taking 4 wickets in his first game in 3 years. Then Harding went on to bowl and took 2 wickets, where 1 wicket was off his own bowling, and it was his first catch ever. He was delighted, and so was the whole team. Goff did bowl with the ball also. He didn't get any wickets, but he slowed down the run rate with figures of 9-7 off 2 overs. Dolan's performance with the bat also continued on the field, taking 1 wicket with a great economy rate and getting a vital run out when the wicket was needed to be taken. Campbell never looked like reaching the target, losing far too many wickets with their number 6 batsman being their top scorer of only about 10. Their total score in the end was all out for 58 off 15 overs. So Assumption won this game convincingly by 57 runs, and with every other bloody game being called off and cancelled and washed out whatnot, Assumption were on top of the table with 4 points and Campbell were on the bottom. The highlights of the game were Lyle's duck. Everyone thought he'd make a decent score. I was out for a quick golden duck. Then there was Tom Goff who was getting very excited for himself because he was batting at number 6. But soon enough he proved that he belonged to the lower order because he was confused with the sport he was playing. He thought he was playing a game of golf, but it was actually a game of cricket he was playing, and from that resulted in him losing his off stump. Crowley and Nixon, 30 plus runs for the thirds. Great knock for them. We may see them being promoted to the ranks. I bowled out my friend, David Reeside, who I knew personally. After 10 overs, we realised, oh shit, we left Webby on the bench. We forgot to swap him. Poor kid, but it didn't matter because he was a Collingwood supporter. The celebrations of wickets were really great because we got together as a team, and Colin Grandy's speech when he was going, his speeches were really, really motivating. And at the end, the winning celebration with the skipper chaired off as if he's played 100 tests and was going to retire, and the group photo at the end.